There are no rock.
There. Perfect. Two minutes, it may be important. Thank you.
Yeah, all right, everyone, are we ready for this? Of course not.
Why does it feel so heavy?
I
all to me. And then I had to go upstairs and give him a head psych on the street. Like, oh, I didn't know where I was. She had an attitude. Like, what the hell? Like,
all right.
You don't have to talk to me. Exactly. So I brought it up to her because I don't think you know how she acts. I don't have time for it. Like, I can't. But maybe she might have been trying to be able to say this. Please.
I'm sorry, but, you know.
I was just like, I can't. She would just come up.
Yeah, we started up the middle fourth row from the front.
should be.
It's like we drop in a couple frames and the quality kind of just started slowly decreasing.
Okay.
Probably so, like literally since we went last time.
Okay.
Did you check the line?
This line is fine. This one that your PC is connected to.
Change up a bit.
Okay. So how are you connecting to your PC?
That streaming device.
Much smarter. Okay.
Yeah.
So then your PC is going out over Wi-Fi now?
Yeah.
That's why it's slow. That's why I thought that it'd be better to connect your PC with the hard line.
Gotcha.
You know what I mean?
I was having a bit more of an issue.
The other way?
The other way.
Gotcha.
And so I brought in like a streaming device and I'll just do this way.
Okay.
But as long as your line's fine. Because it was at 1080 and it was like beautiful during rehearsal.
Yeah.
And then it dropped to 720 and then it went to 480 and I was like, oh.
And it's currently on what?
Question.
Sure.
Should I be watching where my head goes during the performance for your video?
You could try to sit.
Sit a little bit this way?
Okay. Yeah, maybe. Yeah. 720 currently. Is there any
air conditioning? Any air
conditioning for what? Testing.
Like testing the output? Yeah, there's a warm monitor that internal. I don't know what it is. I know what it is on Mac.
That's it.
I'm an expert.
You're gonna be an expert.
An expert. Just one thing that.
That was great, and it wasn't as good. Thank you. heroes of sustainable development in the audience. We're in for a very, very special evening. I'm Jeffrey Sachs, Special Advisor to UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres on the Sustainable Development Goals, and Special Advisor to the wonderful person I'm going to introduce in a moment. Before I do, I want to thank all of you for all of your leadership. There are many leading business people in sustainable development, many philanthropists, many diplomats, many senior government officials here tonight, and it's a thrill to be able to be together with you for what will be an absolutely spectacular evening. We're here to celebrate the planet, a sustainable planet. We need it, as we all know. We've also decided to make SDG 18 good traffic in New York on the week of the United Nations General Assembly. People will be continuing to come in as they beat the traffic on the east side, and thank all of you for making it for welcoming those who are on their way. We have a spectacular evening of great artists, and we're going to start with two of the most wondrous people in the world, and I just was together with both of them. It gives me absolute thrills to see them together. Of course, we're going to experience the magic, and there's no other word of Yo-Yo Ma playing this evening. He is a great gift, of course, to the world in the arts and also in the United Nations. He has been for a dozen years UN messenger of peace, and boy, has he lived up to that role. My wife and I know Yo-Yo from college days, actually, which was the great gift of our college years, knowing him. And we will never forget when our family, our young children, first met Yo-Yo, because he was a star of Mr. Rogers. Which was, of course, very important for our four-year-old. And when she met him, she looked at him and said, "You're real!" The truth is, he is sublime, as we know. So he is both real and sublime, and we're going to be enjoying him and all of the virtuosos this evening. It's a remarkable group and remarkable composers with new compositions. I'm grateful that this is an effort together with the UN Sustainable Development Solutions Network and our wonderful partner, the International Institute of Applied Systems Analysis, IASO, one of the great research institutions of the world. You'll be hearing from the director, Pavel Kabat, in just after the intermission. We're also grateful to SDSN Youth and to all of the supporters and sponsors and generous donors who have made this evening possible. Especially want to thank the mission of Israel to the United Nations and the government of the Netherlands and all of the other supporters. It's my enormous pleasure and honor to introduce to you my boss also, and my inspiration and our leader in the Sustainable Development Goals, a most remarkable person. UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres oversees this complex world and the United Nations, and he has asked the Deputy Secretary General of the United Nations, Amina Mohammed, who is known to all of us, to lead the effort on the Sustainable Development Goals. She is a force of nature and has played a role that is absolutely unique in bringing about the goals. She was the special advisor to Secretary General Ban Ki-moon on the negotiations of the Sustainable Development Goals. So she brilliantly managed the global diplomacy to bring them to reality. She went back to Nigeria to become the Minister of Environment of the federal government of Nigeria, and of course was helping to lead in that country as she has for many, many years. She was also the director of the Millennium Development Goals Office for the President of Nigeria for many years, a decade ago before she came to the UN. Well, as soon as she went home, she was called by our new Secretary General, Secretary General Guterres, come back to New York, we need you. And indeed, she has come back to lead wonderfully and with enormous energy and creativity and constantly asking and pushing and cajoling for more. This marvelous and unique effort that all of us are on. So it's a tremendous honor and pleasure to introduce to you the Deputy Secretary General of the United Nations, Ms. Amina Mohammed.
Thank you very much, everyone. And I thought Jeff was going to say I was a sister of another mother and not the boss. But good evening, and it is such an absolute privilege and honor to share an evening with all of you listening to you. And thanking Jeff and all the supporters here for having us. Celebrating the Sustainable Development Goals through music is a wonderful expression of our commitments to our human family. The SDGs were born out of a truly historic process, 4 years of it, where the Global Village came together and gave birth to 17 goals. The music tonight, I hope, will unveil the depth and their beauty through the notes that we will hear that should move our hearts and minds and unite us for just a moment. At the end of the evening, I'd like to think that you would take that moment and bring it into your lives, both professional or otherwise, and take it out there to make a difference in the world. And really to bring the opportunities of each one of those goals as an entry point to make a difference, to bring solidarity, to bring respect, to bring dignity, to bring tolerance to a world that really is full of such tragedy, such atrocities. We've almost lost our way. Where is our humanity? And this evening, I want to bring us just a little closer. We have a crazy week at the UN, and we'll bring together leaders. And we hope that some of those speeches will move hearts and minds. But I hope that it is in this hall that we can do that, and that we can show them the change that we really need to be. So I look forward to enjoying this evening with you, and hope that we will definitely move hearts and minds to achieve the 17 goals. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. How can we meet the needs of a growing world population within planetary boundaries?
Postcard project brings the story of very young composers, their story of their life in music. And we bring these short compositions to classrooms, to rehearsal studios, we connect it to professional musicians, and in this way we bring their voices to the stage of professional music. We make recordings of that, and these recordings we send back to the original very young composer, who's then stimulated to continue the work and to spread their personal message. If we think of the world of 2030, it's very abstract, it's very far away, it's not clear what needs to be done today. The musical postcard project invites very young people to express their dreams and their hopes in music. So we give a voice to the generation 2030, but not a voice with words, but a voice with music. These compositions travel the world. We record songs and pieces of music, sometimes in very remote places, in refugee camps, in children's prisons, or just in a music school somewhere. And in this way, we amplify the real story of the generation of 2030. Tonight we present a composition of Shazam. She composed this herself, and her composition then was again by young people of her age built into compositions for the musicians that you will hear.
I'm Shaza and I'm 13 years old. I am from Syria and now I live in the Netherlands. This is the kanun. It's an Arabic Turkish instrument, and I started playing it when I was 7 years old, I guess. The name of the piece is Locked Up, and it is about being locked up. And I have never been locked up before. And I thought it was cool to just imagine how it could be. I don't wish that technology becomes the boss of the world, because I just want it to stay like that. I just want a human to stay in connection with each other. I think music can play a role, and I hope it will help with keep connecting with each other and stay creative.
Thank you. Are we ready to leave no one behind?
Thank you. it's cool. It's a great production. Yeah, I've never seen you involved. Did you get to meet any of them?
Yeah. I hung out with them the past couple days after the game.
Really? Are you doing like this whole event, or is it just tonight that you're working on? Oh, is that what you're doing?
Yeah. And actually recording as well, so it's really fun.
Is it going like on YouTube or anything?
Yeah, on the United Nations YouTube.
Yeah. Are you doing interns too? Or is that just that 1 year?
No, I was invited this year. I think I'm looking at my schedule and I just put in a YouTube.
Yeah.
And try to help out and find guidance. But I leave in January for like 4 months.
Really? Where are you going?
I'm doing CNN, so it's a month in Helsinki, a month in Malawi, a month in Montana, a month in Nova Scotia.
Wow.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. I love it. It's great, yeah. Can't complain. Are you doing it this
month?
Are you doing it this month too?
Yeah. Definitely many of my colleagues doing a project that's helped me out more than a video.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I'll let you get back to work, but yeah, it's good to see
I
it's been fantastic. Everything's really good.
Fantastic. No, we're fine with him. So he didn't sign our release, but they did say that we're allowed to live stream it. So I'm going to take it.
Half the first.
I have it in email, so I'm
wonderful.
Sorry, I should have written you about that.
Yeah, I was just like, I'll just go for it and ask for a apology later.
Thank you. discovered Bach's cello suites to the modern world. He used to play Bach every morning to sanctify the house. So we thank Yo-Yo Ma for so beautifully sanctifying our house today. In addition to Mahler, Ronen Shapira was also inspired by the Sustainable Development Goals. The Five Continents piece, which we heard before the break, and we'll continue to hear shortly, was inspired by it. But Ronen, in addition, had a more, direct, even blatant response, musical response to the Sustainable Development Goals. My daughter, which is somewhere in the back there, says that it's crazy. I'm not sure. I think it's bitter, it's sweet, it's extreme, a little bit crazy, maybe. But I will do my best to convey Ronen's response to the Sustainable Development Goals, musical response. There is just one problem. This piece does not fit with the jacket, so bear with me while I take this off.
Here.
amazing musical tour around the globe. Let's thank again the composer and the performer. The next song takes us around the globe and demonstrates the universality of art, but in a different way. The words were written in the 14th century by Hafiz, Iran's greatest poet, in Shiraz. They were translated to German by Hans Bethke in Berlin. They were composed by Viktor Ullmann in Prague. We rehearsed the song in our home near Jerusalem, and we're going to perform it here in New York. You should know that the Nazis did not like at all Viktor Ullmann, and for two reasons. First, his grandparents were Jewish, and second, he composed atonal music. The Nazis have boycotted atonal music. In fact, they have lumped together Afro-American jazz music and Jewish avant-garde music and art, and labeled both as degenerate. As this as this atrocious, racist, and anti-Semitic Nazi poster shows. For his Jewish grandparents, the Nazis have sent Ullmann to the concentration camp in Theresienstadt, and then to Auschwitz, where they gassed him. But his music lives on with us. So let's enjoy some degenerate music to the words of 14th century Hafiz.
Thank you.
How can artists support transformations to sustainability?
You know, science and arts have very much in common. They are both creative, imaginative, exciting, looking to the future. Science and arts, they are both universal. Mathematics, physics, biology, painting, music, dancing. They speak all the languages. But why do we need arts to help us, scientists, communicate this complex, difficult message of development and goals, sustainable futures? You know, many of us scientists believe that hard facts, which science is producing, a lot of technology, a lot of new innovations, will bring us to the sustainable future. But it's not true. We also need to understand how institutions which humans created, how the humans themselves, our behavior will change. Behavior of you and I, that's emotional. That's what we feel. That's
That's how we move ourselves ahead, deep inside ourselves. And this is where the arts is coming into the play. So imagine, coming back to Mahler from the first part of this evening, you are all these fish in the ocean, and you are listening to me here, giving you a lecture with a lot of graphs about how to change the energy systems or whatever. I think the chance that you will leave untouched like this fish is a big one. As opposed to having me here and others, and these fantastic artists, musicians, dancers, who may appeal to emotion when you close your eyes and listen to music or look how they dance. Imagine a woman getting out of poverty, a child going to school. If that is touching you on your heart, then I am sure that you will be fish leaving this place very much changed.
Thank you. no poverty.
Sustainable energy for all.
Sustainable economic development for all.
Steward and cultivate life on land. Promote peace.
Can we have it all?
The environment supplies us with essential goods and services. The environment supplies us with essential goods and services.
Are we ready to leave no one behind?